Hello, Mr. Stapleton. Here it is.
Hal.
Gee. Why didn't you let me know?
I didn't make up my mind till yesterday.
I always knew you'd make it up someday, darling. Oh, you come to see me then?
No, Hal, I didn't. I'm going to work here.
In Domingo?
I answered an ad and here I am, for a while at least.
Just two pieces, wasn't it, Miss?
Yes, that's right. My trunk's coming later. Thanks.
Trunk sounds like you came to stay. Look, Jean, even though you haven't changed your mind, couldn't I see you once in a while anyway?
Of course, Hal. I'll call you just as soon as I'm settled.
Well, couldn't I give you a lift wherever you're going?
Thanks, but I think they're sending a car for me.
Okay. I'll be waiting for that phone call. I'm in the book.
Good night, Hal.
Good night.
Can you tell me whether Miss Dollard's car is here?
Well, I don't see it. Expecting you?
Well, I thought so. Is there a taxi here?
Well, yes, if you can call it that, but it's over at Willow Lake right now with a fishing party. I'll bet you're going to be Miss Dollar's new companion, ain't you?
Yes, I am.
Well, in that case, we've got to get you up there. Oh, Hal!
Oh, no.
This young lady wants to go up to Zenobia Dollar's. Can you give her a lift?
Can I? Right this way, lady. Good night, Bill, and thanks a lot.
Well, anybody think I done him a favor? Maybe I did.
What are you doing now?
Well, after I graduated, I went in partnership with Dad. We're raising thoroughbreds.
You always loved horses, didn't you?
I loved you too, Jean. But now that you've really seen Domingo, maybe...
Oh, I'm sorry, Hal. I wasn't very nice about it when you asked me to live here, was I?
You were entitled to your own point of view. What happened to that career you wanted?
Oh, I had it for a little while. I got to be merchandise manager for a woman's shop in San Francisco.
Didn't you like it?
I loved it, but it was too hectic. My doctor ordered me to take a rest.
So now you're going to work for Zenobia.
What's she, Cal?
Well, she's swell, Jean. Can't understand why she has so much trouble keeping a companion.
She does, why?
A little trying to work for, maybe. They understand the last one left to get married. You probably won't last long either.
Has she always been afflicted?
No. It happened about 2 years ago when she was doing some research in Central America. She's been all over the world trying to be cured. She came home to stay about a year ago.
Must be terrible to be blind. I don't blame her for being a little cranky.
Zenobia's not cranky. A little moody sometimes, but I think you'll like her. Well, there it is. Catch up on your reading.
Oh, you're joking. Nobody lives here.
I warned you to be lonely.
But there isn't a light in the place. Suppose no one's home.
There must be. She never goes out at night.
Of course, Hal. Good night, and thanks for the lift.
Good night.
it is in, isn't she? Can't you speak? Oh, I'm sorry.
Zenobia Dollard.
Yes, Miss Dollard.
You sound frightened. What's the matter, my dear?
Nothing. But it's so dark in here.
Has Mario forgotten to make a light? I'm sorry. Mario! Bring a light, please. I do hope you like me and be happy here, Miss Kingsley. Sorry the car wasn't there to meet you, but I really didn't expect you until morning. Have you had your dinner?
Such as it was. The bus only stopped long enough for a bite.
Well, then you must have something. Mario, bring Miss Kingsley a glass of milk.
Oh, no, please don't bother.
It's no trouble at all. You may find it a little lonely here.
Countryside looked beautiful from the car.
I don't notice the loneliness myself, because the blind are always lonely. Later on, we'll travel, but I'd like to spend part of each year at home. Memories give light to a dark world.
Were you born here, Miss Dollard?
Yes. My grandfather built this house. He spoiled me outrageously. He even allowed me to climb over this beautiful furniture.
Everything is lovely.
The streams I fished in with my grandfather, the lake, the woods, the cattle on the hilltop silhouetted against the setting sun. They're all scenes I can conjure up from memories. But when we travel, I shall have to depend on your eyes. Can you describe scenes vividly?
I'll do my best to please you, Miss Dollard.
Is that you, Mario? Brought your milk, Miss Kingsley?
Yes, but I stopped drinking milk when I was a child.
Then it's high time you started again. Adults need milk, too. You see, I feel responsible for your well-being while you're with me.
Oh, you're very kind, but I...
for tonight, Maya.
Good night. Would you like for me to read to you tonight, Miss Dollard?
Oh, that would be an imposition. Tomorrow will be time enough to discuss your duties. Would you come close to me, Miss Kingsley? As well as though I could see you. There's character as well as beauty in your face. I think you're going to stay with me. I hope you must go to bed now. Let me have your arm as far as the door. Your room is upstairs, of course, next to mine. It will be the only one lighted. I'm going to enjoy having you here. Good night and pleasant dreams.
Good night, Miss Dollard.
Sleep well. And we don't breakfast early.
Thanks. You're very considerate.
My dear.
I can't imagine what you must think of me. Being late for breakfast my first morning.
That doesn't matter. I don't live by the clock. Sit down. I think Mario has brought you a grapefruit.
Yes, thank you.
Did you sleep all right?
I don't know when I slept so well.
It's the good country air.
Mario just brought in your mail.
Will you open it, please? That will be one of your duties. by the way, you had a phone call while you were asleep.
From whom?
From Hal Wintley. I didn't know that you knew anyone in Domingo.
I don't, except Hal. I was amazed to run into him when I got off the bus last night. He brought me out here.
Yes, so he told me.
Here's a gas bill for $60.
That's all right. We buy it in tanks for our light and heat.
Send them a check later.
The Peter Pan summer camp is asking for a contribution.
Send them $10.
Here's a letter addressed to Miss Betty Saunders in your care.
Oh? Forward it to 153 West 119th Street, New York City. She's the young lady you're replacing. I don't think she'd ever been out of earshot of a trolley car until she came here.
Couldn't she get used to the country?
Oh, it wasn't the country. She didn't seem to like Mario. He is an atrocious servant, I know, but he was born on the place and he's very loyal. And I'm afraid if I turned him out, he'd be unable to care for himself. May I have Betty's letter, please?
Here it is.
I'll have Mario mail it. Finish your breakfast, my dear. I'll be in the garden.
No, I'll come with you now.
Of course, Mario wasn't the real reason for Betty's going away. She left to get married.
That's what Hal said. Please don't think we were discussing your affairs. He just happened to mention it when he heard I was coming here to work.
I hope you don't have a boyfriend in San Francisco who's going to come down and whisk you away from me.
Oh, no, there isn't anyone in San Francisco now.
Good. I thought I made it clear I wanted someone free and unattached.
Well, I'm entirely on my own. Well, nobody even knows I'm here.
Except Hal Wintley. I do hope you'll stay, Jean.
Miss Dollard. I know I'm going to like it here.
Oh, of course you are. You may go and telephone Hal now. Mario will show you where.
Thank you. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze.
What a beautiful picture. I'm so glad you chose Wordsworth tonight, dear.
Shall I go on, Miss Dollard?
No, my dear. Let's stop with that beautiful picture. I had no idea it was so late. You read so well, I forget about the time. You must be tired.
No, I enjoy it, too.
But I don't want to wear you out. Run along to bed, dear.
Good night, Miss Dollard.
Good night, dear.
Good night.
Caretaker. She's in excellent health. May I have them, please? Don't you? My lovely Drachenina, I must rob you of a little of your beauty. Strong, my friend, and bring me a new blossom.
Without waking me. I can't understand it.
Why, it's the good country air, Jean. Don't worry about it so long as you feel well.
Oh, I feel all right, but I can't seem to wake up in the morning. It's never happened to me before.
You're just relaxing. It's good for you. Are you dressed?
Yes. I was just about to come down.
Well, then let's go down together. You're such a fine, healthy girl, Jean. You know, I'm becoming more and more dependent on you.
I try to be of help to you, Miss Dollard.
You are. I don't know what I'd do without you. Oh, after you've had your breakfast, I want you to drive down to the village. Mario's off on an errand.
I'd love to.
Good morning, miss.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Stapleton. My, but this place is deserted. Where is everybody?
Oh, they're having trouble down at Jim Stanley's place. Two of his cows died this morning, and now his little girl is sick.
Oh, that's too bad.
Oh, it's been a terrible year, especially for cattle.
May I have a stamp?
Certainly.
Airmail.
Airmail?
Yes, don't you have any?
Well, not much call for airmail stamps. I guess folks around here ain't in such a hurry. How about 2 threes and a two?
We'll compromise on that.
Let me lick them for you.
Miss Betty Sanders, huh?
But I bet he's the girl who used to work for Miss Zenobi before you.
Yes, I know it.
Why, I didn't know you was acquainted with her.
May I have my letter, please?
I'll take care of it for you. Anything else this morning?
Yes, Miss Dollard wants a few skeins of navy blue wool.
Oh, that's in the dry goods department.
It doesn't have to match exactly.
I think we have that. Well, that's it.
I'll take four.
Four? What's she making now?
I think it's another boy's sweater.
Oh, she's always doing something for the kiddies around here. A lot of them wouldn't have sweaters if it wasn't for her.
How much is it?
I'll put down a bill. And remember me to Miss Zenobia.
Thanks, I will.
Yeah?
Oh, if you happen to see her, please don't mention that I've written to Betty Saunders.
No? Why?
Well, she might think it a little strange.
Well, I do, too. Is something worrying you? Now, maybe I could tell you whatever it was you asked Betty and ease your mind right away.
I was wondering if Betty Saunders really left to get married or if there was some other reason.
Why do you say that?
I don't know exactly. But I'm nervous all the time, and I wondered if Betty felt the same way. Oh, maybe it's the house that depresses me.
That old house was a different place when Zenobia was young. Nothing lonesome about it then. Why, folks used to come for 100 miles for their parties.
To wait.
die like the others. I'll be careful not to take too much. You remember your bargain, Mario. And I'll remember mine.
Yes, friends, from this sort of examination, but it looks like poison. Howdy, Hal.
Hello, how are you, boy?
I never heard of any poison weed around here.
Nor me. And I've been farming in this county for 20 years.
There ain't no poison weed around here.
Certainly.
Never heard of any.
I tell you, a plague has hit our cattle.
But there's no outward sign of any disease, that is, that I know about.
How about Jim Stanley's kid?
Ain't you heard? She died about an hour ago.
What'd she die of, Cal?
Well, I'm no MD, and maybe it's not for me to say. But Ma said she took sick about an hour after eating her breakfast.
What are you driving at, Cal?
Well, it looks to me like this cow died of weed poison. So maybe Jim Stanley's girl died of milk poisoning.
You know what that means. The dairies in town ain't gonna buy her milk.
I telephoned the Department of Agriculture yesterday. They're sending an expert.
Good idea, Hal. Now, don't go borrowing trouble. Wait until after an investigation.
I ain't waiting. My herd's worth more than my land. There's been too many cattle dying like this around here. I'm getting out.
He's gone down into his garden, to the beds of spices, to feed in the gardens and to gather lilies. I am my beloved's, and my beloved is mine. Thou art beautiful, O my love, and terrible as an army with banners.
Did I hear Mario come in?
Yes. Thanks, Mario, but I don't want any milk tonight.
You'd better drink it, dear. You know how well it makes you sleep.
I'm not sleeping well, Miss Dollard. I have nightmares. It may sound silly, but I think it's all this milk I'm drinking.
Oh, nonsense. Perhaps you'd rather have some fruit or...
Thank you, Miss Dollard, but I don't care for anything at all tonight. Beautiful, oh my love, and terrible as an army with banners.
Thank you.
up, I'd... Miss Dollard?
She's in her room. We'll hope she sleeps better tomorrow night. Come back quickly.
Got my balance figured up?
Yeah. $27.80. I hate to see it go, Len. You're making a big mistake.
You wouldn't say that if you'd seen the sale of Jim Stanley's place yesterday. Plenty of buyers for the stock and equipment. Not so much as a dollar was bid on the farm.
All this will blow over, Len. It's a mistake to get in a panic and abandon your property.
Common sense. You'd be smart to sell out, too, if you could find a buyer. I just made a down payment on 100 acres over in Turville County. I'm getting out while I've got a herd and a family. Well, the folks is waiting, Bill, so goodbye.
Bye.
Good morning, Mr. Stapleton.
Good morning, Miss Kingsley.
How are you today?
Oh, I'm all right, thank you.
Well?
I've got a letter for you. Looks like Miss Saunders moved again.
Do you remember the day she went away? Did you sell her a ticket? Did you see her get on the bus?
No. Mario must have driven her over to the station.
Ashamed. Your mother was talking to me and I fell asleep. I have no idea what she was saying.
Jean, this is Mr. Moore. Jean Kingsley.
How do you do?
How do you do? Excuse me, I'll tell Mother we're back.
Mr. Moore, Mrs. Wentley was telling me that you and Hal were out looking for poison plants.
Yes, with the usual lack of success.
How could poison weeds suddenly appear in a district where they were previously unknown?
There are many ways. The wind sometimes carries seed hundreds of miles. The birds could bring it. And it could come in fertilizer, feed, or even other seed.
Isn't it rather peculiar that although so many cattle have died, you're still unable to locate the weed?
Yes, it is. And I'm supposed to know where to look for them. That is, where they'd be growing in relation to soil and moisture and so forth. You know, Hal's a pretty good botanist himself.
Could anyone have deliberately introduced the weed?
Well, I don't. Whatever put that idea in your head?
Well, when cattle are dying all around from eating poison plants where there are none, it is rather mysterious, isn't it? Oh, we were just talking about poison plants.
So I heard.
Are milk and cattle poisoning common in America?
Fortunately not. Well, poison plants do spring up occasionally, and when they do, cattle will eat them and poison themselves and their milk. But when it causes the abandonment of entire settlements, it's really quite serious.
Isn't there any way of eradicating the weeds?
There is now. That's why I'm here. Gotta find the weeds to eradicate them.
Oh, I had no idea it was so late. Will you walk to the car with me, Hal?
Sure.
I'm very glad to have met you, Mr. Moore.
Thank you. Hope to see you again.
Only fainted. She may have discovered I'm not blind. Are you all right, Jean? Can you speak now? You faint.
Just come into the room. How stupid of me. I'm all right now.
Can you stand now if Mario helps you?
I am standing.
Come, Jean, sit down and have something to eat.
I don't think I can.
Why, nonsense. Fainting is an indication of weakness, and food will give you strength. Mario, bring her some brandy. Come, sit down. Sit down, Jean. Is Mario getting the brandy?
He's bringing it now.
Oh, Mario, will you bring another glass, please? I'll have some brandy tonight.
He's brought two glasses, Miss Dollar.
Oh.
It's to the right of your knife.
This is your place. You do the talking.
Yeah, come on, Tom.
Well, it's like you heard. I got two dead cows, and I want to know what you're going to do about it.
There's more cattle died since you got here than died before.
And we're tired being told it's poison weed.
Now, wait a minute. There's nothing I can do about it tonight. We'll hold an autopsy on those cows in the morning. In the meantime, I suggest you put your cattle back in the barns and keep them there.
Well, we didn't need you to tell us that.
Maybe we've got them.
We've had autopsies around here before and never found out nothing.
Same again in that
cow. You suppose there could be anything to Gene's idea?
I don't know. I'm ready to try anything. You can't blame these farmers. We tell them their cattle are dying from eating poison weeds, and we can't find a single specimen in the countryside anyplace.
Let's stop by the Dollard home on the way.
It's a good idea. I want to meet Miss Dollard anyway.
Miss Mario, I'm thinking about. Zenobia couldn't be mixed up in anything.
Jean? Or would you rather look at my beautiful plants? Mario, bring some food. Come. These are my beautiful Drachenina. I brought them all from the jungles of Central America. I was going to give them to science. Until I discovered my uncle had gambled away my lands. Now my Drachenina are winning them back for me. All of them.
How can a plant recover your lands?
These stupid farmers are leaving because their cattle are dying. But not from eating poison weeds. The poison I make from Drachenina's beautiful flowers leaves no trace.
That's very clever, Miss Dollard. To drive away the farmers.
Once we owned thousands of acres around here, I'll own them again. When these petty farmers are driven off, I'll buy up all the land for delinquent taxes. Feed it, Jean. Let it drink. With your own strength, you've made it strong. You don't understand. Your own blood. You're going to die, Jean, like the others. But it won't be really dying, because you'll live on in this beautiful plant.
But people will miss me. How will you explain my disappearance to Hal?
When I tell him you've returned to San Francisco without saying goodbye, he'll be hurt. Perhaps he'll be so hurt he'll forget you completely. No one will ever suspect me of anything. Not dear, blind Zenobia. And when I have my lands back again, I shall miraculously recover my sight. Come, my dear. You poor. Give a little of yourself to Drachenina.
Zenobia.
Oh, come in, Hal.
Thank you.
Is someone with you?
Yes. Miss Dollard, I'd like to introduce Mr. Moore.
How do you do, Mr. Moore?
How do you do, Miss Dollard?
Won't you come into the sitting room?
Thank you. Mr. Moore's from the Department of Agriculture.
Oh.
We've been trying to locate the weeds that have been poisoning the cattle around here.
Any success so far, Mr. Moore?
Not yet. We're sorry to bother you at this late hour, but we thought perhaps you might have heard something in the old days that would help us.
About poison weeds?
Yes, Hal tells me your family was the first to settle here.
Yes, they were. The Dollards owned all the land around here. But I never heard anyone mention poison weeds.
Begins to look like this is the first time they've put in an appearance. Has Mario been in all evening, Miss Zenobia?
No, he drove Jean to the railroad station.
The railroad?
Yes.
You mean Jean's gone?
Just before dinner. I was terribly upset. I had no idea she intended to leave me.
Well, I can't understand her going without saying goodbye to me.
She's not well, Hal. That's why I didn't attempt to dissuade her. She's been terribly nervous ever since she came here.
Yes, I know that.
I think she was either on the verge of a nervous breakdown or just recovering from one when she applied for the position.
You may be right about that, but are you sure she didn't leave any message for me?
She didn't, Hal. But she'll probably write to you as soon as she gets back home.
Well, maybe she left some word with Mario. Is he back yet?
No, not yet. But if she did, I'll have him drive over with it as soon as he returns.
Thanks. I'll appreciate that.
I thought you and Jean were becoming fond of each other, Hal.
I had the same idea. We had a little spat this afternoon, but I didn't think that was serious enough to drive Jean away.
Perhaps it's all for the best, Hal.
Maybe. We'll run along now. Don't get up. We'll let ourselves out.
Then good night.
Good night.
Have Hal bring you over again, Mr. Moore.
Thank you, Miss Dollard. Good night.
Good night.
Mario ever took Jean to the railroad. Doesn't seem likely she'd have gone without saying goodbye to you. That's what I thought. Come on, I want to see something. Cold. This car hasn't been used. Something's wrong. I'll look around here. You go for help. The nearest phone's at my place.
Mario! This must be destroyed. They'll hang you if you don't burn everything.
Happened. When we get home, I'll fix you a nice big glass of warm milk.